I envy each one of you. How was your experience adapting to the students here?
Oh, it was great. I was pleasantly surprised at how interactive and responsive they were, how intrigued they were at the topic that I was talking about. And especially the questions coming from operations and finance and marketing folks was quite encouraging, and that on a Saturday evening with such lovely weather. And the kind of questions that they asked were very intelligent ones, so I really enjoyed myself. Thank you so much.
You've been working with Aditya Birla Group for 5 years. Would you like to share your key learnings from this experience?
Yeah, so ABG really didn't let me get bored in any role, so they kept changing me around. So like I spoke about, you know, I was in a plant, then I was dealing with senior leadership, I was dealing with high workmen, all of that. So, and it was my first job, so key learnings were, you know, dealing with ambiguity, dealing with stakeholders. I mean, they teach you all theories and campus, but all these things, they don't really get to you. So yeah, how do you deal with people? Suddenly, you're sort of thrown in a bar under the pole to manage X number of employees. So managing ambiguity, managing stakeholders, senior stakeholders, I think were my biggest learnings in these 5 years.
You have moved from talent acquisition to talent management. Yeah. So how did the dynamics change from one role to the other?
Oh yeah, they really changed quite a bit, because in acquisition, when you are trying to scout talent from the market, at that time, you know, you're trying to place yourself as the best employer, you're trying to portray the good practices, the opportunities that the employee will or will not experience. So at that time, you're in a slightly different space as far as the negotiating power is concerned, as opposed to an employee who has already joined you and has spent 2 years, who knows the in and out, and probably there is a lot more transparency then. And now the employee gets more demanding as to what are you doing about me, and what are you doing about my careers, and where is my next role, what is the organization doing about my learning. To manage those questions are far more tougher than managing questions like why should I join your organization. But luckily ABG has very good practices in place that help us deal with the second part as well.
How does the framework of learning and development different in a fashion industry from the other core industries like IT and manufacturing?
So for example, in IT, your learning and development will be extremely structured, right? Because you have to teach these softwares to your IT folks, and you can just launch it on a platform and they can go through it, as opposed to there are skills that the IT guys aspire to develop, so they will take those extra software learnings, and you know, they will learn how to use a certain application and so on and so forth, as opposed to a fashion and retail industry where stuff isn't as structured just yet. It's very new in modern retail, is new in India. The people who join you are anyway experts in the design field. They've studied design, they've studied merchandising, they've worked in probably export houses that they joined you. So what delta are you going to teach them in their functional area? So it's not as structured as opposed to an IT. So you know, we try and focus more on experiential learning. For example, for designers, travel-based, international travels for them to get inspiration on their trends and designs. And we focus on more behavioral aspects too, which our learning can number the other helps too. Yeah.
The last one being, with 5 years of experience in ABG, as in a leadership role, so what would you say about balancing profits and people?
So I mentioned this in my session also slightly, and it's interesting that you asked that now, because we just about finished some goal setting discussions in our zone. And by that time, I was sort of telling my business head, so when he was, you know, plotting that this is the revenue my team has to focus on, this is the EBITDA margins that they have to focus on, the gross margins that they have to focus on. And it was sort of stopping at that. So I said, you're stopping at the what, and why don't you define the how? And let's recognize the how of the people as well. So let's put in some process-oriented goals as well. Let's put in some innovation-oriented goals as well for them. And that balance is sort of key to drive business.
Can you tell us something about learning and development that you practice in each generation?
So I spoke about the 70-20-10 framework that we practice in ABG, which has proven to be quite effective because it gives them a combined experience of doing on-the-job projects, of learning from the experiences of others, the leaders in ABG via coaching assignments, and also a very structured classroom training program. So that's working very well with us.
Thank you so much for sharing all this.
Thank you. It's great to be here.
Thank you so much. It's great to see you. We all want to see you again.
Yes, for sure. I shall come back.
My experience has been great. Thank you.